Amen. I don't complain no more. Because I know, hallelujah, that all things will work together. And the reason why I do this is because, see, several years ago, when I was praying, I guess maybe 20 years ago, when I was praying, and I was, every morning I was praying, and the Lord began to put into my heart the desire to write books. And boy, if it hadn't been for that, praise God, I'm not sure whether I could have sustained myself, you know, many times. Because I remember many times I've gone to places I needed $10,000, and I came back with $10,000. That's from the books. You know, sometimes I was at rock bottom, and it seemed like everything that I ever had worked for all my life was kind of contingent upon me doing maybe $10,000 or $15,000 at this particular place. But all of that was born, amen, at the altar, just praying. I never knew that God would just open up so many doors for me to connect with so many people all over the nation and all over the world. Amen. And in the midst of giving, most of it to sustain the work of the Lord. Amen. God has opened a door that no man can close. It was a gentleman that called me from East Moline last week, a couple of weeks ago. He said, Pastor Hill, I've been studying your material for 20-some years. He said, all of my teaching, my church, my ministry is revolves around your teaching. And but that's just one testimony out of 700 testimonies that I have. Now suppose I would say, well, I ain't gonna give up an extra $20. I ain't gonna give up an extra 100. Sometimes it's an extra 1,000. Sometimes it's an extra 5 over a period of year, over the entire year, 10 or 20,000. Amen. Suppose I would withhold good from them to whom it was due. And when I made my appearance before all those pastors, my first meeting in Memphis, Tennessee, it was about 50 pastors all there under this bishop. And this is what this bishop said. He said, Pastor Hill, that was my first effort to put 5 books together, sold it as a package, and told them I got enough material for you to use, amen, for 5 years. You won't have to be scuffling around trying to figure out what to teach. It's all in place, the answers, the explanations, and everything. The lessons are already made. And this bishop said, don't let it all get away. I mean, he said, save me a package, Reverend, save me a package. I came back, my first book took about $1,700. I thought I was really doing good there.
I know that's
right. Hallelujah. Well, the scripture says, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days. Hallelujah. Suppose I had decided to withhold. Amen. Let the church come up with it the best they can. Yeah, I know some of y'all were holding out on me all the time. I'm even tired. I ain't tired enough. Don't come in, it's got to be made up. Since I'm the pastor, who makes it up if the church can't do it? I don't know how many, there have been times we didn't have money to pay the insurance. See that? And who had to stand for it?
All right.
Amen. I could tell you so many things much bigger than an insurance ticket. Amen, but I'm not going to get into that. But I'm showing you that many of us miss out because y'all just inch this little money out. Some of us just inch it out. I mean, if you give $5 above your tithe, that's pretty good for you. And sometimes the need might be $100, $200. And you're in this little box. I don't care what comes. I don't care if the church closed down. I ain't going to give a little more than that 20. I'm going to give my tithe. But I ain't gonna give nothing more. See, mercy, the Bible says, God is the God of mercies. God is touched with the feelings of our infirmity. He can relate to everything that we go through because He's already gone through it. And see, we got to come to the point where we got to, we got to be able to relate to what the money that you're giving for the church is doing. Suppose, you know, I know there are a lot of churches in Tulsa, but you might want to consider how many churches are really praying. I know a lot of them are playing, but how many are what? Praying. How many would like to, would rather be in a church, maybe it's not as big as some of the most renowned churches, where people are trying to do right. You know, we ain't got too many people that's deliberately trying to do wrong. But you don't have a whole lot of people that go into the club and, amen, running and catching. And go down the list. At least somebody that you have some confidence in, you can respect and believe in. Amen. Praise God. Amen. So that should be worth something. Now, I don't know if you could go to any church and you could be in prayer, like Sister Dorothy put on, 30 days, whole month, where you can come, pray for an hour and a half or 2 hours. Monday night, Brother Travis is here. Amen. Sometimes we do it every morning. Pastor, come down with you. I don't just tell y'all, come. I mean, don't do what I say do. Don't do what I do, just do what I say do. I'm not that kind of pastor. If I call a prayer meeting, I'm at the head of the line. First one to get here. Most times I have to be the one to open the door every time. I'm pretty well, unless it's Monday night. So here's the thing. If God is full of compassion, God of mercies, and we can't see the importance of contributing and going beyond and making a sacrifice, amen, and going beyond the call of duty many times to support the work of God and the man of God, then God is on one track and you are on another one. So where there's no union, if you ain't hooked up with God's will and God's purpose and God's plan, if you don't have God's heart, then y'all are going what? Different directions. And results are what? Impossible. And I'm going to tell you, you might be able to hold on to it, but something down the line is going to what? Cause you, amen, cause something to happen. What? A lot of it is that you what? Have held back from the, amen, the work of God is going to what? Be released into something that is crazy and stupid that you could have avoided. Hallelujah, if you had just what? Been obedient to the voice of God. Now that was the woman of the widow of Zarephath, but she heard the voice of God and she was willing to what?
To obey.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
And because she placed herself in a position where the mercy of God could reach her, amen, the Bible said not only did she get one meal, but she was able, her and the son, praise God, and the man of God were able to eat what? 3.5 years. Just because she placed herself in the position where what? God's mercy, hallelujah, could reach her. How many want to place yourself in a position? That's the reason why, amen, I have placed myself, I'm not boasting, in a position now. Anything I touch now, I guarantee you, God is going to bless it. I don't mean a little. I don't mean a little fold. It's going to be like a what? Thousandfold, because, amen, I have what? I planted thousandfold seeds. Amen. That son said, Pastor, that's you. Hey, praise God. Not me. And let me tell you the joy I have in my home. Yes, we have plenty to see. No, top of all of that, Now, Jesus, I'm kind of saying, sometimes I forget, you know, you get carried away. can't get it right every time, but she's behind because I decided she wasn't in agreement.
Come on, man, say that.
I couldn't do it. Amen. So the other one, I says, honey, I'm gonna have to pay this $800, $900 note this time. Did the saints have a chance to give on it? Yeah. Will they give? No, they took it and give it. Somewhere, spend it somewhere else. Now, the real problem you have with this is that it's going to affect you more spiritually than financially. Because when it comes to having a real prayer life, that's the secret of a prayer life, a person that's sold out to God, willing to what? To give everything. Paul said, I count all things but what? Loss. The secret of what? Soul winning and being successful in the kingdom of God, amen, is that spirit like the little widow had. She was willing to what? To obey God.
Yes.
And to what? Take God at his word through the man of God.
Amen.
Amen. Now the same story can be told about Elisha and Naaman the leper. The only way that leprosy was cured, at first he didn't want to what? He didn't want to do what he was told to do. That's right, sister, you haven't been a priest. Because they wanted him to go down and dip 7 times in that dirty river. And he said, this is the man with the leprosy. He said, there are 2 or 3 clean rivers over here. Why can't I go? And he might say, he looked at the man of God, told him to go and what? Dip 7 times. And if you dip 7 times, you will come up clean. Your leprosy will what? It will go. He didn't want to do it. He said, I want to go to the clean rivers and dip. His servant talked some sense into him. He said, look here, if the prophet had told you some great thing to do, you would have done it. Why can't you do the little simple thing that he told you? So he finally what? Gave in, went down to that dirty river, and went down 7 times. And when he came up on the 7th time, the 7th time, what? His leprosy was gone. See, he had to place himself in a position. See, some of y'all ain't willing to do it. You ain't willing to do it. You ain't ready. Because, amen, if we ask you for $25 up and above, whatever you say, amen, you normally give, you what? Balk, complain, and always what? Grumbling. Don't ask for $150 once a year. And usually the money, what? We take it and what? Amen, praise God, and praise God. Pay something that needs to be paid to the church. I mean, we don't go on vacations with your anniversary money. We don't buy no clothes with your anniversary money.
Amen.
I thought I was going to be able to go on vacation, but what? Some needs came up. I had to what? Draw it out.
All right.
I'm ready to go. I ain't through yet. I'm just dealing with some issues, some reasons why many times the blessings of the Lord evade us. Because of our little peanut brain, man, we just squeeze. Amen. The average person, if I said $100, man, you have to praise God. You have to go through all kinds of changes. And end up, you know, more than likely, a lot more doing. I'm ready to get out of here. But I got a whole lot more examples. I just did 2. Touched on the 2nd one. But I got a whole lot more that will give you a clear understanding of why many of these mercies that God has, and God is full of eager yearning. He wants to bless you more than you can imagine. But you got to place yourself in a position where these blessings can reach you.
Amen.
When you place yourself, they'll come on you and overtake you. They'll run you down. You don't have to hallelujah. You don't have to seek them no more. Those blessings will come seeking you. How many can say amen?